To the United States now, the U.S. Congress is currently reviewing a request from President Barack Obama to authorize a new war in Iraq and Syria. Meanwhile, this week marks 12 years since the United States invaded Iraq for the 2003 war. Correspondent Alexandra Hall spoke with veterans and their families as they continue to cope with the wounds of those wars.
Activists at the Spring Rising teach-in in Washington, D.C. know the long-lasting effects of war in a way that most people hope they never have to. It's been 12 years since the Iraq War began, but for parents of deceased veterans like Kevin Lucy, some memories don't fade so easily.
On June 22, 2004, I came back from work at 6:45, and I was looking for Jeff, and I couldn't find him.
Just months before his suicide, Kevin's son Jeff had told his sister he was nothing more than a murderer. He was admitted to a hospital, but was later released.
When I saw him, I thought he was standing, but he was hanging. I ran over there, and he was in my lap for the last time. It should have never happened.
Today, 22 veterans kill themselves in the United States every day. And while those rates are often attributed to PTSD, experts say guilt also plays a role.
A lot of this has to do with the moral injury of one betraying themselves, who they were as good people before the wars and the things they had to do while in war. And then secondly, the moral failings of these wars, that these wars are based upon lies.
Lies that the Bush administration admitted to in 2006.
The main reason we went into Iraq at the time was we thought he had weapons of mass destruction. It turns out he didn't, but he had the capacity.
This week, President Obama openly acknowledged in an interview that the group known as the Islamic State grew out of the U.S. occupation of Iraq.
ISIL is a direct outgrowth of Al-Qaeda in Iraq that grew out of our invasion, which is an example of unintended consequences, which is why we should generally aim before we shoot.
As Congress reviews a request to authorize military force once again in the region, this time to fight the so-called Islamic State, parents like Kevin try hard to forget what happened the last time. Alexandra Hall, Telesur, Washington.